Now that we've added a device to our project, I want to show you what fields are being populated in the databases. Ideally, you'll rarely need to make manual changes here, as my recommendation is to stick to the I/O device manager. But there will be troubleshooting situations where this information will be useful. I'll begin with my I/O devices database. Each record in this database points to a source of data on the network, as well as some system devices on the server. Here we see the name we added in the I/O device manager, the protocol, and the Modbus address. Different drivers using different protocols use the various addressing fields and databases differently. Power Modbus sets its Modbus address in this address field, then references a port in the ports database, found under components and mapping. This port contains the IP address in special options. ION devices communicating over Ethernet, by contrast, store their IP addresses here in the I/O devices database, and they all reference a single ION port. I say this as a warning that finding a device's address from the databases may take some hunting. In an upcoming video, I'll show you my preferred method to keep track of the devices. The other reason to bring you here is for this memory field. If I set this to true, the device will be put into memory mode, meaning the runtime will not attempt to communicate to the field device and will not throw a communications failure alarm. I can write my own values to the memory mode device, however, making this field invaluable for testing. That does come with its own warning when restoring a project, of course. If you aren't reading real data, make sure your devices aren't in memory mode. The next database to see is equipment, under the system model. Here is the device I added, and the type is its profile, which is a useful troubleshooting tool for verifying devices were added correctly. There are a number of other fields here used in various places, but note that the equipment record points to a single I/O device. In another video, we'll look at a situation where we have multiple equipment referencing the same I/O device. Next up are the variable tags that we selected in the profile editor. The tag name is formatted as I/O device slash tag name. We set the equipment and I/O device in the I/O device manager, and the rest of the fields come from the profile editor. The only other tag I'd like to point out is this EE health. It's associated with our equipment, but is read from a system device called network tags dev. This tag is populated by the I/O server in runtime and is used by the communication failure alarm. It's managed automatically by the I/O device manager and generally shouldn't be modified or removed. The other tags we'll review in later videos, but I'll point out that if we added any onboard alarms, PC-based alarms, or trends in our profile, there will also be tags populated under these two tabs. This was a brief look at the final output of the profile editor and I/O device manager. I don't expect you to work directly in the databases too often, but it's important to know where the configuration is so you can, especially when you start troubleshooting. In the next video, we'll get back to the I/O device manager and look closely at what happens when you update a device in the databases. Until then, thank you. Thank you.